Hello everyone, welcome back to our channel. Today's topic is the triangles of neck. In the neck we have already covered the deep cervical fascia, carotid sheath and the facial spaces of the neck. So now we will continue with the topic triangles of neck. Those who have not subscribed to our channel, subscribe now so that you will receive the continuation of the head and neck classes, histology, embryology. In our channel we have introduced the new playlist Important Anatomy in 50 videos. If you go through the 50 videos, you will be able to cover 60 to 70% of the anatomy questions for the exam preparations. So please do subscribe now, keep watching the videos. Now we will move on to the topic triangles of the neck. After dissecting the deep cervical fascia, if we start with the dissection of the neck, we have to know the triangles of the neck, then only we can identify the important structures in the neck. So we will start this. So this side of the neck is somewhat quadrilateral in shape, bounded in front by the median line of the neck, behind by the anterior border of the trapezius, above by the lower border of the mandible, a line extending from the angle of the mandible to the mastoid process, and by the superior nuchal line, below by the clavicle. So these are the boundaries of the side of the neck. In this side of the neck, we will divide this side of the neck into two triangles by the sternocleidomastoid muscles. So this quadrilateral area is subdivided by the sternocleidomastoid muscle diagonally into anterior and posterior triangles. So this is the side of the neck, in front midline of the neck, behind anterior border of trapezius, above lower border of the mandible, body of the mandible, a line extending from the angle of the mandible to the mastoid process, and by the superior nuchal line, below by the clavicle. So this diagonal area, this quadrilateral area, is divided by this sternocleidomuscle into two triangles. So this is the anterior triangle with the apex below and base above, and this is the posterior triangle with the apex above and the base below. So now we will see the anterior triangle of the neck. So there are two anterior triangles on the two sides of the neck. They occupy the side of the neck in front of sternocleidomastoid muscle, boundaries in front midline of the neck, behind by the anterior border of sternocleidomastoid muscle, same base directed above, formed by the lower border of the mandible and a line extending from the angle of the mandible to the mastoid process. So up to that is the base of the anterior triangle. Apex is below and is formed by the suprasternal notch of the manubrium sterni. So this is the two triangle. So this is the trapezius muscle, same. This is the sternocleidomastoid muscle. So side of the neck is divided into two triangles, and this is the anterior triangle and this is the posterior triangle. Anterior triangle apex is below and base is above. So this is the base, formed by the lower border of the body of the mandible and a line extending from the angle of the mandible to the mastoid process, below by the suprasternal notch of the manubrium, behind by the anterior border of sternocleidomastoid muscle, in front by the midline of the neck. So now this anterior triangle is subdivided into many triangles. So this is the anterior triangle. This is subdivided into many triangles. Now we will see that also. Each anterior triangle is divided into 3.5 triangles by the muscles, anterior and posterior bellies of digastric, and by the superior belly of homo hyoid. So these are the muscles. So this is the anterior triangle. So these are the two bellies of digastric, anterior and posterior bellies of digastric, which are attached to the hyoid bone. And one more belly is the superior belly of homo hyoid. Inferior belly of homo hyoid is present in the posterior triangle. So only these three bellies separate this into 3.5 triangles. So what are the triangles? We will see now. Yes, that is the anterior belly of digastric, superior belly of homo hyoid, posterior belly of digastric. So that anterior triangle, each anterior triangle is subdivided into 3.5 triangles: muscular, carotid, digastric, and half submental triangle. Half of the submental triangle is shared by the anterior triangles of both sides. So this is the diagrammatic representation of the triangle. This can be drawn easily by the students. They can note this. So this is the clavicle, and this is the mandible, lower border, and this is the midline of the neck, and this is the trapezius muscle. So this is quadrilateral. It is divided into two triangles by the sternocleidomastoid muscle, and this is the anterior triangle with the apex below and base above. And this is the posterior triangle with the apex above and base below. Each anterior triangle is divided into 3.5 triangles by the three bellies. These are the anterior belly of digastric, posterior belly of digastric, and superior belly of homo hyoid. So the triangles are the, this is one triangle, muscular triangle, and this is the another triangle, carotid triangle, and this is the digastric triangle. So it's some, it is given here submandibular, but the common name according to the nomenclature should be the digastric triangle. And this is the half submental triangle. So these three muscles are attached to the hyoid bone. So this is the diagrammatic representation of the divisions of the anterior triangles. Muscular triangle in front, midline of the neck, behind and above by the superior belly of homo hyoid, behind and below by the anterior border of the lower part of the sternocleidomastoid, floor by the sternohyoid, sternothyroid muscles, which are the infrahyoid muscles. Contains this muscular triangle, the name itself tells, muscles. It contains no important structures except the floor muscles. Yes, this is the muscular triangle in front by the midline of the neck, behind and above by the superior belly of homo hyoid, behind and below by the lower part of the sternocleidomastoid. Floor is formed by the sternohyoid and sternothyroid muscles, and it does not contain any important structures. So we have, in this class we have seen the subdivisions of the side of the neck into anterior triangle and posterior triangle. Anterior triangle, we have seen the subdivisions into 3.5 triangles: muscular triangle, carotid triangle, digastric triangle, and half submental triangle. And we have seen the muscular triangle boundaries and also the floor, and which does not contain any important structures. We will see the carotid triangle in the next class, followed by the other digastric and the posterior triangle. So keep watching the head and neck classes. Those who have not subscribed to the channel, subscribe now.